Well, we stay with the agility world, and now it's the rescue dog agility. Rescue dogs, of course, play an enormous part in our lives throughout the country. But what a special occasion to come to Crufts 2012 for their agility competition. To take you through, delighted to welcome Natalie Ingham.
Thank you very much. Thank you, everybody, for coming here and getting up early to come and watch us. We have a real treat for you today. Joining us in the main ring are a wonderful selection of rescue dogs. They all come in different shapes, sizes, breeds, and ages. The teams here today are Battersea Dogs and Cats Home, the Blue Cross, National Animal Welfare Trust, Wood Green, and Val Grey's Border Collie Rescue. These dogs have all previously spent time in their respective charities for a multitude of reasons. Each have gone on to wonderful new homes, and now, as part of other hobbies and activities, they compete in agility. Today is about demonstrating how trainable rescue dogs are and showing off some of the many skills that they have learned. These dogs are here to have fun, so please get behind them, cheer, clap, and support these great dogs and the charities that they are representing today. So, first up, we have got Frank. Rachel rehomed Frank at the age of 6 months old. He attends training twice a week, including obedience and agility, and additionally, Rachel likes to teach him tricks at home, like singing. He's won lots of rosettes for both agility and obedience, and last year, Rachel won Handler of the Year and Frank Best All-Round Dog. Rachel says Frank is such a lovely dog and he will do anything to please. She could not have chosen a better dog. And he's a fantastic ambassador for his breed. Well done. Next up, we have got Missy. As a rescue, Missy came with a few issues, but Rosie has been able to channel her energy into agility and her behaviour is constantly improving. She's been competing for 2 years and has been very successful in this short amount of time, although she does believe that one run is never enough. And we'll always try to do it again, even after going over the finish line. Well done, Missy. Benji's up next. He came when a litter of puppies were taken to the trust after they had been given up to a vet from an accidental mating. Lizzie was looking for a new dog to fit into her family and found Benji amongst the litter. Soon after he came home, he fitted in perfectly. Lizzie and Benji first tried agility on a dog holiday and thoroughly enjoyed it. Since then, they've joined a local club and started competing in 2005. And isn't he doing well today? Give him a big round of applause, everyone. Next up is Bailey. He's a lurcher cross who likes the sound of his own voice. He was rehomed when he was 18 months old by Debbie and had endless energy. He suffered with separation anxiety and was destructive in the home, chewing TV remotes, duvets and tables. Agility has helped with his training, and as you can see, he absolutely loves it. He's now an old boy, but still thinks he's 2 years old, so give him a big round of applause. Well done. Now, here come our second group. And first up in our second group, we have got Jimmy. Jimmy is a working sheepdog who was found as a stray, wandering along the side of a road. He was taken in by a man who thought he could look after him, but unfortunately, after a few months of keeping him in a shed, he decided that he didn't want him anymore and asked Val Graves to rehome him. He was in a real dirty state, smelled and was underweight, yet when the pictures appeared on the website, Jimmy's loving face won him a new home and family to love him. Chris has been involved in dog agility for the past 20 years, and as you can see, he's done really well today. Matty, next up, was an unwanted puppy from a puppy farm in Wales. Dave rehomed Matty when she was only 4 months old, and it was his first agility dog. They have been competing in agility since 2006 and reached grade 5 in 2007. She's now beginning to show her age, and Dave says he'll probably retire her from competition soon. So let's give her a big round of applause. Well done. Next up is Woody. Woody's a Barrow Hound, Lukey mix, who was found as a stray. He's had an unsettled time as he was rehomed because he didn't get along well with the cats and then was returned. Jan decided he was the dog for her and has invested lots of time in training into Woody to help with some of his issues. She found that he really enjoyed obedience classes and then decided to start agility. He's taken to agility really well and can be a very fast dog. And here he comes over the jumps now. Oh, he's just missed one, so she's sending him back round. And let's cheer him on because he's doing really well. Well done, Woody. Twiggy is up next. Now, Twiggy came into Battersea due to her owner no longer being able to look after her. She was very overweight, and Sophie had to introduce her to a very strict diet and exercise regime to combat her obesity. Now she's active and full of life, hence her new name, Twiggy, and her eagerness to compete. She used to take part in Temptation Alley, but no longer can because she eats everything that she can find, hence she competes in agility instead. So give the group a real round of applause. Now we've got the third group coming in. And as you can see, Holly is raring to go there in front. Holly is 3 years old and she was adopted from Belgrade 2 years ago. There were 32 applications for her, so it was a real honour for Heather to be chosen for her forever home. Holly had been neglected and badly treated. She was very thin, nervous, and had cigarette burns on her head. Now she's a real happy, confident, sweet, and funny dog. She loves her cuddles and lots of fuss and attention. She's a real Miss Bossy Boots to their other two dogs and has brought lots of joy to their home. She started agility training last summer and loves it. So she's not been doing it for very long, so she's doing really well today. So let's give her a big round of applause and cheer her on at the end there. She's coming over those jumps. Hasn't she done well? Next up is Jessie. Now, Jessie was found on the A3 on a half-term weekend. As a result, she now has a fear of vehicles, especially big vans. She's been competing in agility for 7 years, and Sue hopes that one day they will get to grade 4. She says she has never been a cross champion, but she will always be her champion. Her pet name is Messy Jessie, as she doesn't like being groomed. Well done, Jessie. And now we have Tara. Tara was rehomed from Wood Green Animal Shelter with her mother Meg 3 years ago when she was 4 years old. And as you can see, she can have a little bit of a mind of her own. And she's decided she's going to go off and do her own little course. So let's give her a big round of applause to help her get back on track. As you can see, she's a German Shepherd cross Irish Wolfhound. And she's deciding that she's quite enjoying having a little bit of a wander and a sniff around today. So let's see if we can get her back on track. And there she goes over the jumps. Let's give her a big round of applause, everyone. She does love agility and she will have a go at anything, but being quite tall and no longer in her prime, she can turn like an average cruise ship. So she does struggle going around the turns. She participates for fun, really, rather than competing. She does also do obedience classes, but doesn't always demonstrate her skills when she's out of the class. Tara and her mum, Meg, have recently adopted a third dog called Pippa, and Tara's looking forward to teaching her all she knows as well. Let's give her a real big round of applause for finishing up, people. Next up, we have got Blue. Blue has lived with Sandra since September 2005. Sandra says it was love at first sight and he has turned out to be a great dog, albeit at times he can have a mind of his own as well. Blue is part of an agility club in Cranbourne and so far he has competed at a couple of shows. He has good and bad days, but on her bad days, Sandra tells him that who wants to be perfect anyway? And it looks as if today potentially is one of his good days. So let's give him a big round of applause as well. Well done, Blue. And he's just finishing up and isn't he wonderful as he goes over those jumps? Oh, and he's decided not to go through the tunnel, but to come out the other end. Well done, Blee. Okay, now, we're having to lower the jumps because, you might have guessed, our next group is made up of lots of tiny dogs. So we're going to make the jumps a bit smaller to help them get over them with their little legs. First up in this group, we have got Wallace, who is a poodle. Now, Kimberly first rehomed Wallace when he had lots of issues. He didn't like being left and loved chasing vehicles. And he's just getting ready to get going in a second. As you can see, she's getting his attention, making sure he's focused and preparing herself. And off they go. So he's gradually worked on all of his problems, including his energy and enthusiasm, which has been better guided into agility, which he loves. It's a perfect sport for him because it keeps him both mentally and physically active. Since starting to compete, he has already won several classes and has a cabinet full of rosettes and trophies at home. And he's just whizzed through that course today. Next up is Mac, the Jack Russell. He's named Big Mac because he was the largest in his litter. Mac fell asleep on Martine's lap when she first met him, and he has continued with that same rather laid-back attitude ever since. By his first public appearance at Discover Dogs, he had worked out that it was actually quicker to go under the jumps rather than around them. nonetheless, he has realised he quite enjoys this agility lark and has started to make progress, although that might be famous last words today, but he's doing quite well coming over those jumps and through the tunnel he goes. Well done. Alfie is our next one. He was brought into the shelter when he was just a year old because his owner was unwell and unable to do any training or socialising with him. And he's decided he's getting a bit shy today. Let's give him a round of applause and see if we can coax him out of the tunnel that he's hiding in. And he's gone back in. Oh. Let's see if he'll come out. You gonna play? No. Let's see if he'll come out. We're gonna miss the tunnel and start with the jumps. Can everyone give him a round of applause and coax him on? Oh, well done. He can be quite stubborn, as you can tell. And Sally has rehomed 5 other dogs since working in rescue and says that Alfie has proved to be, as you would guess, the most challenging of all of them to train. He can be very stubborn. He's deciding to go under the jumps. And if he doesn't want to do something, he won't. This is his first time in public and he does enjoy going around the track. So let's give him a big round of applause. Maybe next year he'll do better. Next up, we have Woody. Now, Woody arrived at Battersea in 2007 after he had been found roaming the streets as a stray. First and foremost, he's a very much loved family pet and an absolute joy. He's lovable, friendly, outgoing, and has an adorable character, constantly making everybody laugh. He's doing really well, as you can guess, at agility and has already gained several rosettes. And he's just flying around that course today. Well done, Woody. Ollie is our last dog of the day. Jenny rehomed Ollie from the Blue Cross in 2006. She's a typical terrier and has a very independent streak, but she does everything on her own terms, and nonetheless, Jenny has trained her up to grade 5 in agility. So let's give her a big round of applause as she's finishing up the course today. And haven't all the rescue dogs done really, really well? And it's all for a bit of fun. It's not serious competition. It's all just to have bit of fun with the dogs and show how well they can do. So we're going to get all of the dogs out in their respective teams in a second. And as you can see, we've got a range of dogs here from rescue today. They all come in different shapes and sizes. He's just decided he's not going to move today and wants to stay in the centre of the arena, being carried out. But yeah, as I said, a range of dogs, all sorts come into rescue, some through no fault of their own. A few rescue dogs can have a few problems, but as you can see, with a little bit of training and TLC, they've all come a real long way and can do really well. They make great, fabulous pets. And let's just give all the teams a wonderful round of applause. So today we've had the National Animal Welfare Trust, Battersea Dogs and Cats Home, Wood Green, Blue Cross and Valgrave. And if you're thinking about getting a new dog, why not go along to one of the stands today and have a chat with them? I'm sure we'd all be able to find you whatever you're looking for, whatever shape, size, and temperament. And they make fantastic dogs and pets, and you can really get them to do all sorts of things, as we saw today. So give them a big round of applause and cheer them on as they're leaving the ring. Well done, everybody. I think you'll all agree that was great fun to watch. Thank you very much.